outside, when you get there, I want you to jump and jump and jump. And then you read that you are feeling big money. Praise God. God has done it. God said jump. He didn't say leap. There's a difference between jump and leap. Hallelujah. We try to, you know, put our Christianity the way it will fit you. Hey, make my head turn off. Praise God. Papa, you do well. Do it the way God asks you to do it. If God asks you at the end of the service today, be the only one that will clean this church. Not go and ask somebody, say, hey, I want clean church, you go join me. No. Do it. Whatsoever he tells you to do, do it. If he wakes you up 3 a.m. at night and say, pray. I need to start work by 5:30. Pray. Forget about 5:30. He that makes the day will take care of 5:30. Is somebody getting what I am saying? Am I communicating here? He said, whatsoever he tells you to do, do it. And when the hour comes, look at the madness of the whole thing. Jesus said, go carry pot, fill it up with water. The disciples supposed to ask, say, oh God, they need drink, not water. But because they have been with Jesus, they know the signs and wonder that this little guy always performed. Listen, anybody that will underrate you, they will miss the miracle. Are you hearing me today? My goodness. He said, put the water, fill it up. They fill it up. Everyone, people that were watching, thinking, what kind of nonsense is all this? Listen, God might tell you to do something that is crazy. Hello? I don't know if you get what I'm saying. Papa was saying something. He said, God, I was preaching, and God said, anybody that can give 500,000 naira between now and next Sunday, please come out. He said, people just get up. And then they came out. 500,000 naira. He said, but there was this young man. You know, his job is on fire. Problem everywhere. And what is happening is just around that amount of 500,000 naira. He said, but the young man came out and said, Daddy, I have listened to your word, but this is the check. And he said, he was trying to tell him, your job is shaking. He said, but the Holy Spirit said, collect it and put it down. He said, he took it. He said, a week later, the owner of the companies want to close the company. And they are paying off everybody in that company so that they can go and look for another job. He said, but the owner came and brought out a list. Every other person in that company was laid off. But him alone was retained and transferred to Lagos. Amen. I don't know if you get what I'm saying. Amen. He said, sometimes I speak unusual things. And God, Jesus was speaking unusual things. Fill it up with water. Put it, put water. And when he filled up, he did not say, hey, Father, Holy Ghost fire, turn this water into wine. Oh, everybody pray. Say, blood of Jesus, blood. No. Hallelujah. I told you a couple of weeks ago, I said, God said, don't pray too much prayer, just declare. If you come to me and say, this is what you are having, and I say to you, it is well, go with it. Don't expect me to shout. Hallelujah. Don't expect me to do what? Because God is moving me to a new level of anointing. A new level of anointing that I don't even need to shout and yell before I decree. When you just like say, it is where go. When I tell you that, don't wait and say, you don't finish. I didn't say you go pray. I didn't say you go pray. Hallelujah. Jesus said, begin to serve. He didn't pray. He just said, have you finished putting the water? They said, yes. He said, serve them. All the big guys sat down. They draw the water. They wanted to see if this water will turn to ordinary water. They turn it, they give the big guy. The guy sapped a little bit. Read it in your Bible, it's right there. He sapped it a little bit. He said, hey, give me the mic. I said, what do you want to say? He said, why is it that in every party, they will always sap the sweet wine first? So that the latecomers will drink the bottom one, the one that is not sweet. He said, but you people allow us to drink the one that is not sweet. Now you are drinking the sweetest wine of all. How did it happen? The hand of Jesus. The problem in your life require only one touch from Jesus. That high blood pressure require only one touch from Jesus. That migraine headache require only one touch from Jesus. That immigrational document require only one touch from Jesus. When Jesus walk out that miracle, you will sing a new song. Amen. When Jesus walk out that miracle, you will dance a new dance. Amen. You will declare, said, he put a new song in my mouth. Amen. And he made my feet to stand and dance like ever before. Because I have seen the goodness of the Lord in my life. Hallelujah. I think in Isaiah 44 verse 23, I think we read it the other day. He said, sing for joy. Burst into praises. Shout. He said, because I, the Lord, has done it. Tap your neighbor and said, I don't know what you are going through, but God said, I should tell you, it is over. No. That is the voice of somebody who is about looking for bread to eat. Tell somebody, say, I don't know what you are looking for, but God said it's over. Tell another person, I don't know what that problem is, but the problem is over. Make it a third person. I don't know what that problem is, but today, heaven said it's over. Give it up to Jesus. Time will not permit me, but if you get home, you can read it. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 4, from verses 1, the Bible said there was a woman. Her husband was a borrower. You will never borrow again in Jesus' name. Every one of you that did not to be a borrower today, I put an end to every borrowing in the name of Jesus. Anything you will have will be your own. You are buying car, it will be your own. Member for this ministry, you will not lease a car. You will not finance a car. You will pay cash for that car. Because we serve a living God in the name of Jesus Christ. You read it from verse 1 in 2 Kings chapter 4. The Bible said there was a man. There was a man. He borrowed and borrowed and borrowed and borrowed and borrowed. He go borrow buy food. He go borrow pay school fees. He go borrow buy shoe. He go, in fact, the wife, they dress anyhow. But everything on her is borrowed. May not that be your portion. In the name of Jesus. And they came, the man fell and died. Do you know why you carry a lot of problems? Problems can kill you. Hello? Let it out. There are outlets. You can let out. Let it out. That pressure that is mounting on you, let it out. Sing praises unto God all the time. You walk into your room and sing. Dance. The Bible said the man died. And the creditors came and said, I'm a dad, very sorry. Oga was a good man. Why? Because he always a borrow now. Or he's a very good man. He was one of my favorite customers. As a matter of fact, they saw the body that he has not paid though, anyway. I just said, let you know. Don't be saying that man I come for, but I just to let you know. Hallelujah. The creditors come. Anything that will embarrass you in life, God will put an end to it. Amen. That amen is too small. I didn't hear that. Do you know what it means for something to embarrass you in life? Anything that will embarrass you in life, God will put an end to it. Anything that will make people to mock at you, God will put an end to it. Anything that make people to say, hey, God, look at that, God, look at him. It is another. God will put it down. They came. After they have celebrated, they say, hey, madam, if you don't have money, we will take your two sons. The Bible said the woman ran. She did not meet any of her in-laws or relatives or uncles or friends. She ran to Elisha. Man of God, I have a problem. And what is the problem? My husband used to borrow and borrow and borrow and borrowed, killed him. And now the people want to take my sons away. And the man of God, do you know what the man of God said? He said, what do you want me to do? Hallelujah. What do you want me to do? What? To do. She's a member of a church. She paid her tithe. She paid her offering. She was expecting the man of God to call for general collections. Bring that offering, boss. Let us help this brother. Anything you have, God love a willing mind. But the man of God said, what do you have in your house? He said, man of God, I have nothing but a little oil that is in my house. He said, you know what you want to do? I know that borrow killed your husband, but I still want you to go. You are not borrowing money this time. Borrow vessels. Hallelujah. Borrow what? Vessels. Collect it. Bring it. Put it to your house. Man of God, what will I do? When you get in there, lock your door. You and your sons. Begin to pour in on every vessel. And by the time they are filled up, then I will tell you what to do. The Bible said, when she finished, she came again and said, man of God, he's filled up. He said, sell it and pay your debt. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. Pay it and do what? It is only God that has solution to your problem. The people you are narrating yourself to, they don't.